Growing up, this face just inspired trust. Why? Well, because you're looking at veteran police officer Pete Malloy, who along with his partner Jim Reed, did their very best to keep the streets of Los Angeles safe. Of course, I'm talking about the TV show Adam 12. I'll talk more about that show in just a moment, but first let me introduce myself.
Hi folks, my name is Dave Sundstrom, and I like to think of myself as something of a pop culture historian, especially when it comes to music, movies, and television. Simply put, I love talking about this stuff. So with that said, let's get rolling.
Debuting in 1968, Adam 12 was a police drama that followed Los Angeles Police Department officers Pete Malloy and Jim Reed as they kept a watchful eye on the streets of Los Angeles in their patrol unit 1 Adam 12. The series was co-created by Jack Webb and attempted to realistically capture a typical day in the life of police officers. I'll be talking about Jack Webb again before this video is over. But before I get to my list of 5 things you might not know about Martin, I've also got to mention this show, Route 66. It was Martin's first TV show where he was the star. Truthfully, I don't know if I've ever seen an episode of this program where Martin played a character named Todd Stiles who encounters all sorts of adventures while traveling up and down US Route 66. By the time Martin was offered this role, he'd been acting for well over a decade, which brings me to my list. The first thing on it that you might not know is that Martin nearly died in 1946 after making his first movie, Life with Father, which starred William Powell and Irene Dunne. Martin was stricken with polio. Because this was almost 10 years before Dr. Jonas Salk would develop an effective vaccine against the deadly disease, Martin would spend almost a year recovering. The second thing that you might not know about Martin is that his first appearance on television was in a 1950 episode of The Lone Ranger titled Pay Dirt. Things don't go all that well for Martin's character as he's shot in the back and left for dead, but you never know what masked man might stumble upon the scene of the crime and bring those devilish no-good nicks to justice. You never know. Wait, you probably do. Yeah, it's the Lone Ranger. The third thing that you might not know about Martin Milner is that in 1952 he joined the Army, where he was assigned to Special Services and assisted with the direction of training films for that branch of the military. While stationed at Fort Ord on California's Monterey Bay Peninsula, he was there at the same time as another great actor, Clint Eastwood. I don't think the two of them hung out or anything like that, but they were definitely there at the same time. While still in the Army, Martin was able to do a little bit of radio work on the side during the weekends. This is where Jack Webb comes back into the picture. Martin had worked with Jack previously on the set of the motion picture The Halls of Montezuma, and Webb had been extremely impressed with the young man's work ethic. Because of that, he offered Martin a chance to work on the radio version of Dragnet, where he played Officer Bill Lockwood, who was briefly a partner of Sergeant Friday, as well as other characters on the show. Martin's close working relationship with Jack Webb is the fourth thing that you might not have known about him. The fifth thing is that he was extremely close to his Adam 12 co-star Kent McCord. Not only did the two actors continue to find ways to work together after Adam 12 ended, but they remained good friends throughout their entire lives. A couple of projects that the two worked together on after Adam 12 were 1989's Nashville Beat, where Martin and Kent again played crime-stopping partners. In fact, Martin's final on-screen role in 1997 in the season 5 premiere of Diagnosis Murder would again team him up with Kent. On September 6, 2015, Martin died of heart failure at his home in Carlsbad, California at the age of 83. A memorial service was held by law enforcement and community members 6 days later. Additionally, to further honor Martin, the Los Angeles Police Reserve Foundation posted a badge online bearing a black band and the number of Officer Pete Malloy. Los Angeles Chief of Police Charlie Beck said this about Martin at the time of his passing: Adam 12 and Martin Milner embody the spirit of the LAPD to millions of viewers. His depiction of a professional and tough, yet compassionate cop led to thousands of men and women applying to become LAPD officers, including me. One more thing about Martin. The feller was an avid fisherman. After retiring from acting, he looked for every opportunity to spend time doing one of the things that he loved most. And he also did his best to share that passion with others, which included hosting a radio show about fishing called Let's Talk Hookup on a San Diego area station. Here's another video that I think you'll enjoy. It's all about Kent McCord and a particular moment that changed his life forever.
Okay, now it's your turn. Please share your memories in the comment section and don't forget to like and subscribe. But most importantly, thank you for watching.